take this opportunity to introduce a good friend of mine. In grade 9, I used to steal his dessert. And at about 4 foot nothing, there wasn't a whole lot Jamie could do. 25 years later, a few things have changed. He's taller and we're both a little bit more polished. Now I just make him buy me lunch. When most of our friends left the Sault in the early 90s, we started our different businesses and we experienced a challenging start in real estate. We both rooted ourselves in the community and through hard work, built established businesses and started our families. Jamie now has the track record both in business and politics of coming up with well thought out solutions and ideas and doing the work necessary to follow through to the end of a project. Reliability is key in a top position like that of mayor, and Jamie has proven this time and time again. I don't normally like getting involved with these kinds of campaigns, but I'm here because I believe strongly in Jamie's ability and the contribution that I know he can make to Sault Ste. Marie as mayor of our city. His dedication, work ethics, and diligence in getting any task done makes him qualified for the job. He has absolutely no chance in beating me in a game of squash, but the guy just doesn't give up. I'm here because of my confidence in Jamie Caicco as future mayor of a community that I was born in, raised, educated in, and work in. I have children whom I want to make Sault Ste. Marie their home. I'm here because Jamie's heart is in the right place and he's going for the mayor's job for the right reason. He truly cares about the citizens of this community. Please welcome my good friend and the next mayor of Sault Ste. Marie, Jamie Caicco.
Friends and supporters, thank you for coming tonight. I know everyone here has very busy schedules, and I appreciate you being here. At 3 p.m. today at City Hall, I registered as candidate for mayor in the upcoming election. I've been keeping this very secretive, and I know it's a shock to everyone here. I want to talk to you about a few things tonight. My vision and plan for the city. I want to talk to you about the upcoming campaign. But first, I really need to thank a few people that made it possible for me to be here tonight. First and foremost, my family. You can't make this type of commitment without this kind of commitment and sacrifice without family support. My wife Tiffany has given me unconditional support in all my ambitions, this included. Sometimes this type of work takes away time from the family. They understand and accept that. So thank you. To be successful, a strong political foundation is required. I've had that. And I need to thank the two counselors I worked with in Ward 1 over the last 10 years. Working with them has helped put me in a position to run for mayor. First, David Orizzetti. I served with David my first term on council from 2000 to 2003. It was a great 3 years working together. We accomplished quite a bit in the ward and in our city. And throughout the term, we became pretty good friends. Actually, let me qualify that. When speaking to an NDP or conservative person, I say our wives are friends, and we just get paired off. Actually, a large part of our good fortune in recent years has been through the efforts of David, and I look forward to continuing to work with him as mayor. Then came Steve. After 3 years with David, I thought I knew everything. Once I met Steve, I found out I had more to learn. Steve has been amazing to work with. I don't know a person who has served our community longer with as much dedication and effectiveness as Steve. And Sault Ste. Marie is very fortunate to have him serve the community.
Yeah.
I can tell you, it isn't easy to find help 1 year before an election. So far, I've had some great help. Don't think I'm as IT tech-savvy as I am, Brad Madigan has been just wonderful with the computer and the internet. The campaign cards, which I'll be meeting homeowners with, Jeff Alge at Lucidia, they're very creative. They have a great design team. My business cards from Lamons Printing. And then I've had great resources, Brady Irwin, Ian McKenzie, and just people coming out of the woodwork and supporting me. Craig Hull, you know, he asked me yesterday, can I bring coffee? Can I bring coffee for everyone? Can I bring cookies? And Craig, if you want to pay for the pizza, that's fine too. And then lastly, Joe Ruscio. Joe Ruscio is a typical accountant. He makes me buy him lunch, then he keeps the receipt. That means. Joe has done anything that I've ever asked of him. He's a great person, and he's a great friend. Let's talk about the election. I'm very excited about this election and the possibilities for our city. The future is very bright in Sault Ste. Marie. And together, in the coming years, we have a real opportunity to move our community forward. I have a plan for our city. It's an ambitious plan, but it is achievable. It's a community action plan that will emphasize what we feel is important. Having a vision and a plan is crucial to a community. Some of the infrastructure projects and economic initiatives that a council influences are long-term, sometimes lifetime decisions. The leaders of a community must capitalize on our strengths and opportunities and have a clear understanding of where we should be in 10 or 20 years. I'm going to outline the three parts of my community action plan. The first is we'll focus on the economy and jobs. 10 years ago when I was elected to represent you at City Council, that was my focus and it will continue to be. In recent years, our city has done fairly well compared to others that have struggled. We need to keep that economic drive alive. To accomplish this, our transportation links are crucial, and any of those projects must be pursued. At present, we would be hard-pressed to find industrial land that's ready for a development. This is crucial, and industrial land that is ready is critical, and this must be addressed. In attracting new opportunities, we must leverage our larger businesses in town for complementary attractions. The city has done a fabulous job in attracting alternative energy projects. We have a real opportunity to attract a manufacturing component, whether it be windmills or solar panels. We need to focus our efforts on this. Having sat on the EDC board and the Chamber of Commerce, it's given me a very good perspective on the business community. I've always thrived on economic development, and by helping local businesses, whether it's updating the local zoning bylaw or supporting the new businesses that come to town, I commit to you in doing everything to creating an attractive environment for business opportunities.